Widely known for her on-screen roles in the Jurassic World franchise and the Netflix series Black Mirror, Bryce Dallas Howard has been in show business since the early 2000s. Her other movies which won her accolades were Spider-Man 3, The Help, and Terminator Salvation. She has also tried her hands at direction, screenplay, and production. Here are 10 things you probably didn't know about Bryce Dallas Howard. How she got her big break. Long before she starred opposite Chris Pratt in Jurassic World, Howard began her acting career on the stage. She had an affinity for acting from an early age, and her father could clearly see it. Perhaps that's why he allowed her, at 7 years old, to be an extra in his films. After graduating from high school, she developed her acting skills at NYU and honed her talents at the Steppenwolf Theatre Company's school in Chicago. Instead of hopping into movies or television shows right away, she concentrated on the stage and was cast in several New York City theater productions. It was at one of these productions, the William Shakespeare comedy As You Like It, in which she played Rosalind, that she caught the attention of director M. Night Shyamalan. The acclaimed director chose to cast her in his then-upcoming movie, The Village. In it, she played the blind daughter of the chief and fellow lead actor Joaquin Phoenix's love interest. Though the film was panned by reviewers, her performance in it garnered praise and led to more box office winners for the red-headed stunner. Shyamalan enjoyed working with her so much on The Village that he also cast her as the lead in another movie, Lady in the Water, where she starred opposite Paul Giamatti. The rest, as they say, is history. She dropped her last name at the beginning of her career. While the idea of having celebrities like Ron Howard and author Cheryl Howard as your parents would sound pretty exciting to anyone else, Bryce Dallas Howard is living proof of the contrary. In fact, as she told Peter Travers in 2015, she chose to avoid association with her famous family when she was just beginning to act in stage productions by billing herself as Bryce Dallas until she realized it sounded like a porn name. What is even more embarrassing is the origin of her middle name, which her father actually revealed to David Letterman as a reference to the Texas town in which she was conceived. Her father mistook Jessica Chastain for his daughter. It has been a running gag for years in Hollywood that Bryce Dallas Howard bears a striking resemblance to her fellow red-headed The Help co-star Jessica Chastain. The similarities between the two are so strong that even Howard's dad has confused them. In a 2019 interview with the Associated Press, Chastain said filmmaker Ron Howard once walked past the Interstellar actress at an Apple store before muttering, "I think I just saw Bryce." Howard confirmed that the story was legit in an interview with Entertainment Tonight, saying her dad was, like, shook. He really was. At first, he was like, "You really look so much alike. And I mean, obviously, I'm incredibly flattered, so it's great." Black Mirror traumatized her prior to appearing on the series. The potentially detrimental effects of an obsessive abuse of technology are commented on brilliantly in Black Mirror, especially in an episode starring Howard as a woman desperate for her peers' approval in a utopia, ran on a 5-star rating system. No one was more surprised by her casting than herself, who, while promoting the Netflix-exclusive anthology series' third season, showed Conan O'Brien a distressing, tearful video of her describing her first viewing of the show as a nosedive. Coincidentally, Nosedive is the name of the episode she gives her manic, SAG Award-nominated performance in, which surprisingly did not require her to tap into her earlier nervous breakdown to achieve, as a hidden talent of hers could do the trick. She knows how to cry on command. In a guest appearance on Conan O'Brien, she came on to plug the 2015 release of Jurassic World. At one point in the interview, O'Brien brought up the actress's ability to cry upon direction, which she then demonstrated by having the host ramble about the Home Depot, while her eyes begin to well up more and more. During her aforementioned return to promote Black Mirror, O'Brien enlisted Howard to teach him this talent, but to no avail. She actually trained to run in heels for Jurassic World. Speaking of Jurassic World, one task that Bryce Dallas Howard actually had to undergo serious training for was something that her character, Claire Dearing, ended up getting a lot of flack for. The unbelievable sight of the actress running from the unleashed T-Rex while wearing high heels became one of the most widely criticized moments of the film despite the practice she had put in to make the scene genuine. Howard would later defend the scene in an interview with Cosmopolitan, citing the heels as a reflection of Claire's disconnection from the reality of the park's hostile environment due to corporate blindness and the mere fact that running barefoot could have been just as dangerous. She loves directing. While she is an accomplished actress, Howard has also worked behind the camera as a director. In addition to her directorial debut, Dads, in 2019, she has also directed two episodes of The Mandalorian and an episode of The Book of Boba Fett for Disney+. In an interview with Den of Geek, she said that she loves directing and hopes to be able to direct many features in the future. Her daughter inspired a memorable Baby Yoda moment on The Mandalorian. Another iconic moment more favorably associated with Bryce Dallas Howard is the sight of the child, better known to fans as Baby Yoda, sipping a cup of soup in the fourth episode of The Mandalorian, directed by Howard. However, despite becoming one of the most popular images from the Star Wars spin-off series, it would not have appeared during the Mando and Cara Dune quarrel if not for Howard's then six-year-old daughter, who, according to the director's interview with TV Line, commented on the lack of Baby in the early storyboards. Showrunner Jon Favreau then realized the child's presence should be apparent on the series as much as possible, resulting in this and many other adorable moments from the season. She graduated from NYU 21 years after she originally enrolled. Howard graduated from New York University's Tisch School of the Arts more than two decades after she originally enrolled in 1999. In May 2020, she shared a photo with a caption, "I am so overcome with joy to share that I have officially graduated from NYU. I first enrolled in undergrad in 99, then took a leave of absence to start working as an actor, so this has been 21 years in the making." She called the academic feat a dream, even though she wasn't able to attend an in-person graduation and walk across the stage, like many graduates, following stay-at-home orders amid the coronavirus pandemic. In a lengthy letter penned to her fellow graduates, Howard explained that she left NYC in December 2001 for an off-Broadway acting job. "I fully intended on graduating one day. In fact, I continually deferred the following semester and the semesters after that, hoping that instead of dropping out, I was simply taking a leave of absence. Again, and again, and again." She subconsciously chooses projects her kids will get excited about. While celebrating Lint's Gold Bunny ahead of Easter 2022, the Jurassic World Dominion actress told People that her son Theodore and daughter Beatrice were excited about the kinds of projects that she got to work on. She said that her kids liked that their mom gets to work with dinosaurs and Baby Yoda. She added that Beatrice was particularly impressed to hear that she was working with John Cena and Dua Lipa on the upcoming spy film Argyll. Howard said, "I couldn't believe it. My daughter knew everyone that I was working with. She was like, oh my gosh, I was such a big fan of John Cena. I love Dua Lipa. I'm like, who are you?" Howard is thankful that her kids are supportive of her work, sharing that their enthusiasm is definitely a good thing, because work will sometimes take her away from them. She added, "That might even be subconsciously one of the reasons why I lean into projects that I know they'll be excited about. Because they're making sacrifices as well."